This DNews episode is brought to you by Domain.com. If you were born without half your brain, doctors wouldn't give you much of a chance for normal life. But a woman in China is proving them all wrong. Hey friends, it's Trace. Thanks for watching DNews. You know how I talk about how awesomely awesome the brain is at rerouting connections and adapting? Here is the perfect example. A 24-year-old woman in China complained of dizziness and nausea to a doctor, and eventually they put her into a CAT scanner. She was missing her whole cerebellum. Are you freaking out yet? The cerebellum sits below the two brain hemispheres and contains 50% of all the neurons in your brain. Imagine if half of your brain cells were just not there. Scientists believe your cerebellum is how we control our motor skills, maintain balance, and manage speech. They also believe it assists the two hemispheres in emotion, memory, and attention. And this woman was born without one, and yet doctors say she's not functionally disabled. The study in the journal Brain explained the woman doesn't have difficulty speaking or coordinating her movements. She hadn't learned to speak until she was 6 or walk until she was 7. But again, without that part of her brain to control those things, it's a surprise that she did any of those at all. This case is a testament to brain plasticity. We've talked about this before. Brain plasticity is the ability of the human brain to compensate for changes in the environment or the human body, like learning to walk again after a stroke, or in this case, learning to walk at all without the motor center. When you lose a finger, the neural representations of other fingers around that get bigger, and it's commonly known that when you lose one sense, the others heighten to compensate. But still, how did this woman learn to walk or speak without the part of the brain that helps you walk or speak? Doctors believe the functions normally reserved for the cerebellum were picked up by the cerebral cortex, the brain's outermost layer with all the little wrinkles. Normally, the cortex assists in the regulation of motor control, sensory information, and association. That is to say, you know, perception of the world around you. This case shows how plastic the brain really is, and that this woman lives a relatively normal life. Aside from her feelings of dizziness and a mild mental impairment, she was able to marry, have children, and understands the world around her quite well. This is not even the first case of a missing cerebellum. There have been 9 cases. The first one was in 1831. Without CAT or MRI scans, most of the cases were caught after death, like in 1940, when a 76-year-old man was found to have lived his whole life without a cerebellum. Whether the woman will live to that age, though, is unknown. Doctors will surely be studying her progress moving forward, though. Thanks to brain plasticity, it's not just the cerebellum that can go missing without effect. Wired magazine reported earlier this year that a man who was born without the connections between his two hemispheres is 88 and lives a relatively normal life. A scientific case study written about him suggests that aside from trouble drawing or using both hands at once, he's lived normally. In 2007, New Scientist reported that a man's head was basically a hole instead of a brain. 50 to 75% of his skull was full of cerebrospinal fluid instead of brain tissue, with only a thin layer of his brain around the edges and through the middle. And yet, he worked for the government, he had a family with 2 children, you can now make those government jokes that you wanted to make. The human body has an amazing capacity for adaptation and survival. Scientists would have said all of these people should not have survived, but here they are, living their lives. Does stuff like this shock you anymore? Do you know more about any of these cases? Share with us in the comments and let's keep following this woman's progress. Subscribe for more science every day of the week. Thanks for watching DNews. Y'all are great.